Yeah, now see, this was that segment, investing activities. Now see, in investing activities, we will consider only two items, let me tell you. In investing activities, we will consider only two items. And which two items? Only fixed assets and investment. Fixed assets, or you can call non-current assets, okay? And investments, only these two items we will consider. Yeah, now see, those investing activities due to which, you know, there is cash inflow, investing activities which result cash inflow in business. So see, sale of fixed assets, when you will sell your fixed asset, there will be cash inflow, isn't it? Getting my point? Yeah, sale of investment, sale of fixed assets, then sale of investment or securities. Suppose earlier you purchased some investment and now you are selling. So when you will sell your investments or securities, there will be some fund. Some fund will release, and you will get some funds. You will get some money. And third is what? Receiving loan payments. Receiving loan payments means earlier you gave loan to some other party. Understood? You advanced some money to other party. Now you are getting back that money. Now that other party is paying you that money. So receiving loan payment. So these are what? These three are what? Investing activities which result cash inflow in the business. Yeah. Now see, those investing activities which result cash outflow from the business. So see the first. Purchase of fixed assets. When you will purchase fixed asset, there will be cash outflow. To purchase the fixed assets, you have to pay money, and payment of money means cash outflow. Now next is what? Purchase of investments. And third is what? Lending money. Lending money means giving, you know, loan to the other party. So when you will give loan to the other party, there will be cash outflow. So these activities we will consider in which segment? Second segment of the cash flow statement, and that is what? Investing activity. Yeah, now let's solve question based on related to this topic. Calculate the cash flow from investing activities from the information given below. This is the question actually, and this is the last day of the previous year, 31st March 2012, and this is the last day of the current year, 31st March 2013. So you can say that this is the previous year and this one is the current year. And two items are given, machinery, and the second item is 10% investments. So machinery opening value is $10,50,000 and the closing value is $14,28,000. And then the next item is which one? 10% investments. Opening value is 3 lakh and closing value is 6 lakh. And these are the other information, point A and point B. So point A says what? Depreciation on machinery was $1,20,000 for the year. Depreciation on machinery. It means during the year we depreciated machinery with this amount, $1,20,000. Yeah. Now point B is what? Half of the investment held in the beginning of the year were sold at 10% profit. So using these information, now we are to compute what? We are to calculate the cash flow from investing activities. Yeah, now see how to do that. Yeah, so see, cash flow from investing activities. So first you see what we will do. So first we will, you know, consider those items due to which cash inflow, those investing activities which result cash inflow. So we will use this first information regarding machinery. Machinery is there. Yeah, now see what I will do. So first I will consider the machinery. So I will prepare the machinery account. See the machinery account. This is the machinery account. Machinery account. And what is the opening value? $10,50,000. This is the opening value. So opening value I will show on the debit side, because this is asset and asset always show debit balance. So opening balance I will show on the debit side. How much? $10,50,000. Yeah, and closing value is how much? 14,28,000. So that I will show on the credit side. Closing balance that is given. How much? 14,28,000. So opening value on the debit side, closing value on the credit side. Now see the information relating to machinery. Point number one. During the year, we depreciated machinery with 1,20,000. Yeah, so for this we passed which entry? We passed this entry na, depreciation account, debit how much? 1,20,000, and machinery account credit. Machinery account 1,20,000. We passed this entry for depreciation. This is the entry for depreciation, isn't it? Now in this entry, what happened? In this entry, machinery account credited. Yeah, so this entry will be posted on the credit side of machinery account, depreciation. On the credit side, I will write depreciation. How much? 1,20,000. Now you compare both the side. You compare both the side, you will get information. Either, sale of furniture, or sale of machinery, or sale or purchase of machinery. So see, in investing activity, we will consider only sale and purchase. Sale and purchase of fixed assets or investment. So now I have to compute whether during the year we purchased machinery or we sold the machinery. So whatever information given in the question relating to machinery, those information I have used. Opening value I showed, closing value I showed, regarding depreciation I made the posting 1,20,000. Now I will compare both the side and I will find the hidden information. What is the hidden information? I will compare both the side. So tell me total of which side is more. I think total of credit side is more, isn't it? So what is the total of credit side? The total of credit side is, I think, 15,48,000. 15,48,000. And same total I will write here on the debit side, 15,48,000. And 15,48,000, subtract this 10,50,000. 15,48,000, and I will subtract what? 10,50,000. Now let's see what is the amount of balance. 0,0,0, 8 minus 0, 8, 14 minus 5, 9, and this is 4. So 4,98,000 we got. This is the amount of difference. Yeah, so this 4,98,000 I will write here. 4,98,000. And this 4,98,000 is what? Purchase of machinery. Yeah, and when we purchase the machinery, what entry we pass? What entry we pass? We pass this entry na, machinery debit 4,98,000. When we purchase the machinery, we pass this entry, machinery debit and bank account credit. So machinery account debited. So on the debit side, see, we got the figure 4,98,000, and just we have to write only bank. So it means this is what, this amount we computed as balancing figure, and this 4,98,000 is what? Purchase of machinery. And there is no sale of machinery in this question. Only purchase of machinery is there. There is no sale of machinery. So understood how I computed? Because see, in the question it is not given clearly that what is the amount of machinery purchased. That is not given in the question. We are to find out. And to find out that, we are to prepare what? Machinery account. Understood? So let me explain you again that how I prepared this machinery account. So first I will take the opening value on the debit side, then closing value on the credit side. Then I considered this information relating to depreciation, that during the year machinery was depreciated with 1,20,000. So that depreciation I put on the credit side. These three figures given in the question, these three figures are given in the question, isn't it? Then I made total of the credit side, same total I wrote on the debit side, and from this total I subtracted this figure 10,50,000, and then we got this amount, and this is the amount of what? Machinery purchased. Okay, it means I purchased the machinery and I paid this much amount, 4,98,000, and this 4,98,000 now I will consider in my cash flow statement. So this is the cash flow from investing activity. So I will write what? Purchase of purchases purchases of machinery. And what is the amount? 4 lakh minus 4,98,000. Why minus? Because there is cash outflow na due to this item. We purchased the machinery, it means we paid the money, it means cash outflow, and cash outflow means negative figure. Yeah, now see the next item is which one? 10% investment. So see how I will use this information. Just a moment. So in this also I will prepare, you know, investment account. In this case also, like machinery account, I will prepare the investment account. Okay, so see my investment account, 10% investment account. This is the investment account, 10% investment. Okay. So what is the opening value? 3 lakh. So that opening value I will write on the debit side because it is asset. Asset always show debit balance. So 3 lakh on the debit side. And closing value is 6 lakh. So closing value I will show on the credit side. Closing balance 6 lakh. Now see the information relating to investment. What information is given? Read out the second in. Yeah, half of the investment held in the beginning of the year. So in the beginning of the year we hold 3 lakh investment of 3 lakh, isn't it? Yes, and its half will be, you know, 1,50,000, isn't it? 3 lakh and its half, 1,50,000. Okay, and were sold at profit and at 10% profit. Getting my point? And profit means, it means we charged a high price. This is the book value of half of the investment. Okay, and we sold that half of the investment at 10% profit. So 10% of 1,50,000, how much? 15,000. 10% of this. So what was the selling price? 1,65,000. Understood? This is the selling price. This was the book value of investment. This much book value of investment sold for 1,65,000. That's why we earned profit. How much? 15,000 profit. 10%. 10% profit we made. This is the book value, and it's 10% we made profit. So 1,50,000. It's 10%. It's 15,000. So this is the cost price. This is the profit. So cost plus profit, we got the selling price. Okay. So how much price we got on sale of investment? 1,65,000, isn't it? So this I will write here. Sale of investments. And how much price we got? 1,65,000. And cash inflow is there, na? Because when we will sell investment, there will be cash inflow, isn't it? Yeah. So that's why plus positive figure, 1,65,000. Got it? Yeah, now see next. So we got this information. Now see, we are to make entry for this. So first we will make the entry, and that entry we will post in this investment account. Okay, so see what entry we will pass. We will pass this entry. When we sold the investment, we pass this entry. Bank debit, how much? 1,65,000 we got, isn't it? And investment sold, so investment gone na? Credit what goes out? 1,65,000. Understood? Yeah. And one more entry we will pass, and this 1,65,000 is what consists of profit also. Let me explain you in detail this entry. Just a minute. Wait a minute. How much price we got? 1,65,000. This is the selling price. Agree? And what was the book value? Book value of investment sold. Book value was 1,50,000. Agree? Yeah, so how much price we got? So first entry, see the first entry. So we got how much price? Bank will be debited with 1,65,000, okay? Because we got the money. And investment gone na from the business. So credit what goes out? Investment. So how much investment? 1,50,000 of investment of 1,50,000 gone, isn't it? So we are to credit investment with 1,50,000 because the value of investment was 1,50,000, isn't it? But see what we will do. Instead of crediting investment with 1,50,000, we will credit investment with 1,65,000. And this 1,65,000 consists the amount of profits also, isn't it? Nor we are to credit in bank debited with 1,65,000, no problem, because we got the money 1,65,000, and we are to credit investment with 1,50,000 only. But you know, I am crediting investment account with 1,65,000. This figure includes profits also. So in the next entry, it means investment account over credited here, isn't it? Instead of crediting 1,50,000, I credited 1,65,000. It means investment account over credited. So in the next entry, what I will do? I will debit the investment account with that extra amount. And I know that extra amount is amount of profit. So that extra amount I will transfer to the profit and loss account, because that is the amount of profit. Understood? So these two entries I will pass. So now see the posting of these two entries in the investment account. See? So bank account debit, investment account credit. So investment account credited. So on the credit side, I will write bank. How much? 1,65,000. Agree? And in the next entry, see investment account debit, profit and loss account credit. So investment account debited. So on the debit side, I will write 15,000. And I will write profit and loss account. Understood? So understood the posting? Yeah, now see, I will compare both the side. I will compare both the side and let's see if there is amount of difference, if there is any amount of, amount of balance, if there is any balance left. Just a minute. So what is the total of which side is more? I think total of, credit side is more. 1,65,000 plus 6,00,000. So the total will come, 7,65,000. And same total I will write here, 7,65,000. Okay. And 7,65,000 minus this 3,15,000. Let's see what is the amount of difference. And that amount of difference is the amount of investment purchase. So 7,65,000. And what is the total of debit side? 3,15,000. So what is the amount of difference? I think the amount of difference is 4,50,000. This is the amount of difference, so that I will write here 4,50,000, and this is the amount of investment purchased, balancing figure. This is the amount of investment purchased. Okay, so by preparing this investment account, we got two information. First information is what? Amount of investment sold. And second information is what? Amount of investment purchased. Okay. And I already showed amount of investment sold. That item I already showed. Now I have to show this amount. Amount of investment purchased, 4,50,000. So that I will show here. Investments purchased. Just a minute. And what is that amount? 4,50,000. Okay, that is the amount of investment purchased. Investment purchase, it means again money, cash outflow. So that is negative figure. Cash outflow, negative figure. Just a minute. Minus 4,50,000, because cash outflow is there. Got it? Now let's see what is the final result. only this much information are there. Now let's see the final result. The final result will come, you know, 783,000 negative, because in there are two negative figures, 498,000 and 450,000, and only one positive figure. So we got the final result 783,000 negative. And to this, what I will write, what name I will give? Net cash used in investing activity. This is our answer. Net cash used in investing activity.